Guys, good morning. We have been out here for about the past 45 minutes as passengers have been disembarking, and there are still more of them to get off the ship. There are about 2,000 of them that were on board. And most of what we are hearing is disappointment, certainly, but only to a certain extent. There's also a lot of gratitude towards the cruise line for having handled it as best as they could per these passengers. They, of course, got to go to the Bahamas instead of Cuba. But, you know, when you have a trip planned, it's certainly disappointing to see that not work out. If we can show you guys some video, we were there earlier as the ship made its way here to Port Canaveral just a couple of hours ago. This ship was diverted while it was already at sea. It was pretty sudden from the passenger's point of view, and it was because of that announcement from the Trump administration that they were going to do this in order to put pressure on Cuba to stop supporting the Venezuelan government. But, you know, passengers that we've been talking to, some of them understand that these implications stretch far beyond their own vacations. Cubans, the people there, some of them miss out on income from the American tourists who would be coming in as a result of these cruises. But for the people on these ships, a lot of them that we've been talking to, they had itineraries once they got on the island, and many of them don't really have any plans to try to find other means to get back there.
Well, it is not it was something you looked forward to. In my case, we were celebrating my birthday and going to Cuba. I was supposed to meet some people of the government, also bringing some medicine for his dog. So that's something he cannot get in Cuba. So it was heartbreaking, as I am a dog lover.
And the cruise line has posted a statement online that you can find on my Twitter page at Hadass Brown Wesh that outlines kind of the full details of what you can expect and what you can ask for if you are planning to go on a trip that was impacted by this sudden restriction. For the customers who were on this particular cruise line, the Norwegian Sun, what we're hearing from them is that they're getting a 50% refund for the trip and discounts for future travel. Reporting live at Port Canaveral, Hadass Brown, Wesh 2 News.